Deferiprone.
Thank you, Massimo. Thank you, dear friends. I'm very happy to be here to meet you again. And the work that I'm going to show you is a clinical trial that is a clinically based clinical trial. The start point is where we were when with Pierre, we devised the first Idemenon trial into euro-ATAXIA. And where we were is that, in fact, the recovery of heart involvement in euro-ATAXIA given Idemenon has largely 85% of the children had a clear recovery of their heart involvement. This is where we were, but unfortunately, the neurological involvement was unchanged. Indeed, the patient has mentioned a decreased fatigue, an improved delicate movement, improved voice fluency, decreased swallowing difficulties, but gait ataxia was not improved. And the course of the neurological condition was not really changed. By the time of my follow-up of 350 children with ataxia to the care, I was puzzled by the figure of unexplained hypocidemic anemia with low plasma ferritin in many children. Many of them have anemia with hypocidemia and hypoferritinemia. And because of this anemia with hypocidemia, several of them were given iron orally to cure the anemia. And unfortunately, the iron supplementation worsened, awfully worsened the course of the disease, and several children were still walking, but wheelchair bound after iron administration for their anemia. And several of them quickly lost their ability to walk in the following weeks, the weeks following iron supplementation. So my first clinical message is, please be cautious when supplementing patients with iron, even though they are anemic. I think we should rather make blood transfusion rather than iron supplementation. But the scientific question is, what happens exactly? Is protaxin an iron donor for Hansen disease? Is it conceivable that ferrokeratase, which is also an iron superprotein, could be endured in the ataxia by the same mechanism of iron sulfur protein injury? Is it possible that frataxin deficiency would cause a miscompartmentalization of iron? And in a sense, it's possible because we have evidence of iron accumulation in some part of the cell, the mitochondria, and in various tissues as well. So this was an incentive to consider the iron status and possibly iron donation in children with euro-ATAXIA. And from this standpoint, I must say that I learned a lot from the radiologist, the pediatric radiologist, and I learned about the technique that all of you, of course, know, but I, which is the T2 star technique. The T2 star technique is a brain MRI technique that is able to quantify iron in the brain. And so we have been able to devise this tool in our institute, and also to write a program that could not only show iron accumulation but also quantify iron accumulation. And this has been done by our colleagues from General Electric in collaboration with Anne Leroy-Villig, who is a biophysicist, who was kind enough to write for us a program that could not only demonstrate the presence of iron, but also quantify iron accumulation. And on this first slide, you see that this is the dentate nucleus of children, as matured children, and the bottom line are normal controls. Doesn't work. This is normal controls, and you see the beautiful almond shaped dentate nucleus with a homogeneous structure, very nice, bilateral and very homogeneous. And here, you see how altered, irregular, inhomogeneous, and iron dense those non-peptide are early on in the course of the disease. So this is why we considered whether possibly it would be conceivable to make a trial with an iron character. It should act probably as a shuttle, and the iron character would be able to remove iron, label iron, and possibly redistribute iron within the cells and hopefully deliver it to transferrin for recycling. When I asked a question to hematologists, I happened to meet a colleague of us, Yoav Kabanchik in Jerusalem, Hebrew University, who is in hematology by training. He is taking care of patients with thalassemia, iron overload due to thalassemic conditions. And this gentleman knows nothing about Friedreich ataxia, but he knew very much about iron collation, in fact. And he has a great expertise in the handling of a drug called Deferiprone. And Deferiprone is a very well-known, long-known compound that has many interesting properties. The first one is that Deferiprone can pass the BB readily, very easily. Also, Deferiprone acts at very low concentration, and it removes iron accumulating in rat cardiomyocyte at very low concentrations. And also, iron collation, if done, should also spare iron stores and cause no iron deficiency. And this was shown by our colleagues, the hematologists doing iron collation for thalassemia. So there was a body of evidence that this is a harmless compound, available over the counter, and largely used because I think something like 15,000 children are given this compound worldwide. So, of course, before launching a clinical trial, we have to devise a preclinical study, of course. And this preclinical study has been done by Yoav Kabanchik in Jerusalem. And the principle is such, a relatively simple one. Cassin green is a fluorescein analog, which undergoes fluorescence quenching by iron and dequenching when iron is scavenged by a catheter. So you are playing with the quenching and dequenching of the fluorescence of cassin green. So the question was whether Deferiprone could stop the quenching and trigger the fast recovery of fluorescence. And can this fluorescence be applied to cell compartment to estimate iron content within a particular subcellular compartment?